handle.
His last name, yeah.
How am I doing tonight? A little bit louder. I got a lot of fears. A lot of fears. I'm a small person. My biggest fear is that I'm going to have a child that comes out and he's naturally going to be a midget. Off rip. He just comes out naturally a midget. My biggest fear is not that he's going to be a midget and be short. My biggest fear is that he's going to be a midget, and when I have people come over the house, they're always going to be like, oh, he's so cute, he's so precious, why don't you take him to the park? I'm not taking him to the park, he's 35 fucking years old, what the fuck do you mean? He's just home visiting from college, goddamn, he's getting a doctorate, shit! Don't come back over here with that shit, ever. My door is... I got a grandma, man, she's a thug. She's a real thug. I'm talking about one of them thugs that just drive-bys every day of the week. This bitch goes outside, one pants leg rolled up, a do-rag on, and a wig on crooked. She be outside picking corn. One day the wig fell off and she did a drive-by on the goats, mad as fuck. Like, bow, 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 bow. Everybody get down. I don't give no fucks. I don't give no fucks. I'm killing everybody. Squirrel, pigeons, bitches, hoes, tricks, sluts, my cousin Pee-wee, and everybody else in this motherfucker that wanna get some. I don't give no fucks. I'm like, damn, I ain't never going nowhere with this bitch. She crazy as fuck. This can't be my grandma. She's like, shut up and roll the weed. All right, I got you. Man, I got a Mexican friend named Jose. He invited me to church one time, man. I ain't not know what I was in for. These motherfuckers party all fucking month long. Man, this motherfucker invited me to his party. I went to the church. I get through the doors. The motherfucking usher boy passing out shots of Corona and fucking communion cups. The fucking deacon boy was fucking the motherboard. And the damn pastor was giving baptism with cum shots. I didn't know what the fuck was going on. I was like, damn. I wake up 5 weeks later in my front yard, butt naked, with nothing but my cell phone and a cigarette, trying to figure out what the fuck was going on. I called Jose, like, man, what happened? He said, we party, hoes, we just party. I was like, all right, I guess I ain't doing that shit again. I did it again last week. Wednesday night Bible study, we did it again, together, we did it again. Man, who seen that shit on the news about El Chapo escaping from prison? Yeah. All y'all seen it? Because I seen it. The thing wasn't that he escaped from prison. It was the fact that when he escaped from prison, he decided to go in the tunnel and come back for his fucking sandals. Like, nothing. Like, he had enough time. Like, he knew. Like, oh, shit. I gotta go get my shoes. My feet might get cold. Like, what? What pair of shoes does a billionaire need from prison that he can't buy in the real world? Like, what the fuck went through his mind? Like, man, them the new Air prisons. I gotta get those. They don't sell those at Foot Locker. Like, what the fuck? Man, that's all I got for y'all, man.